So I met someone. This is the G70 from Genesis, and I don't know, but I have a feeling we're gonna get along great.
Genesis, the luxury arm of the Hyundai brand, wants you to meet the G70 also. Athletic elegance is how the Genesis press materials introduce their compact sports sedan. This long hood with a short overhang and sloping roofline would suggest they might be right.
Though there's nothing groundbreaking about the front end, it's got this interesting contour line on the hood, and it's definitely sporty. It's got a streamlined profile with hints of movement, like this air vent that's shaped like an arrow, kind of pointing you in the right direction, but the rear is great.
The roofline slopes dramatically and elegantly into the trunk lid, which is raised and has this subtle spoiler. It sort of looks like it's peacocking. The bumper is so well integrated, it's almost invisible. So far, so good. On the inside, there's similar attention to detail, but with a focus on simplicity. There's not a lot of fuss, just what you need, including an 8-inch touchscreen with Apple CarPlay and Android Auto smartphone connectivity. There are enough knobs not to pull driver focus from the road when having to search the touchscreen, and everything feels intuitively placed.
Some of these buttons are a little bit far away for me of the short arms, but once you have everything set up the way that you want it to, between the steering wheel controls and this favorites button right here, everything is one or two clicks away, which is great. One thing I have to mention which is not great, a couple of times I've been on the phone connected through Apple CarPlay, and people on the other end have said that there's a crackling sound. Not just on this car, but on a couple of Stingers as well. So it's a problem that Genesis might want to take a look at.
We definitely got a lot of interior extras on this dynamic edition, like quilted leather, contrast piping and stitching, and brushed aluminum trim bits. But expect lower trims to swap some of these items for less luxurious materials.
These seats are some of the most comfortable I've sat in a while. They're nice and supportive, but without that harsh, racing-inspired bucket seat stiffness. These would definitely be comfortable even in a grueling commute. Though I would not like to endure that back here because this is cramped even for me, but I can move the front passenger seat right here so I can squish them up a little bit, which I'm sure they'll hate. As for the middle seat, I'm not even gonna try that. That's for your poodle. But the design back here is really nice, so at least you will be cramped in luxury.
Now to the good stuff. The driving experience in the G70 is highly customizable. There are 5 available modes that adjust powertrain response, steering weight, engine sound, which actually can be turned off, all-wheel drive torque distribution, and suspension firmness. There's even an unofficial drift mode, according to Genesis execs, if you turn off all the nannies. I can hear Micah drooling from wherever he is right now. From comfort to sport modes, you can even adjust how much these side bolsters on the driver's seat hold you in. Put it in comfort and it can relax its grip on you.
You know, I love it when car companies let people set up their own driving preferences. It speaks volumes about them wanting buyers who love to drive. Hey, that's me.
The G70 was built on a shorter version of the Kia Stinger platform. That's a great car, but Genesis took the biggest nitpick I had about the Stinger and absolutely crushed it.
They reworked the suspension and it's awesome. It's stiffer and it absorbs everything, but it's not harsh or shocking. It's got performance chops, but it's comfortable and doesn't make you feel like you have to go to the chiropractor after a day of driving. Bravo, seriously, it's really good. This car is equipped with a larger 3.3-liter turbocharged engine, and it's punchy in all the right ways. It's got a lot of early torque, and if there's any turbo lag, it's minuscule. Shifts on the standard 8-speed automatic transmission are well-mannered, and the throttle does not make you work very hard. Man, this thing is uber quick. Not like an Uber is fast, but like Uber meaning like a lot quick.
The G70 is light and nimble. It's eager around corners and feels solidly planted. And the steering has great weight whatever mode it's in. Ex-BMW M division head Albert Bierman is now head of vehicle performance at Genesis, and wow, he brought his A game.
I've been driving this car for 3 days and I can't find a place where it's lacking. It's fun, it's exciting to drive, and it's totally confidence inspiring. This car is really well sorted.
The G70 also has a sticker price to love. The 2.0-liter turbo rear-wheel drive starts around $36,000. Standard features include LED headlights and taillights, heated outside mirrors, 18-inch alloy wheels, a proximity key with push start, an 8-inch display with Apple CarPlay and Android Auto, and safety features including forward collision avoidance with pedestrian detection, smart cruise control with stop and go, lane keep assist, blind spot collision warning with rear cross traffic alert, and 3 USB ports, 2 up front and 1 in the rear. Whew, I'm out of breath. That's a lot of standard equipment for less than 40 Gs. The higher up the trim food chain you go, the more goodies come with you, like leather seats, sunroof, heated and ventilated front seats, navigation, Michelin Pilot Sport 4 summer tires, a limited slip differential on rear-wheel drive versions, and Brembo brakes. Across all trims, throw down $2,000 and you get all-wheel drive. For performance-minded drivers, stepping up to the 3.3-liter turbo might be the right call. It's got more horsepower and comes standard with rear-wheel drive, though, again, all-wheel drive is available. On the 3.3T Sport, an electronically controlled suspension is included. Climb up to the top ring of the G70 ladder for the all-wheel drive design edition with exclusive Black Forest green paint, cream Napa leather seats with dark green door panels, and a leather steering wheel that's also heated. And you'll part with more like $52,000. Unlike the Alfa Romeo Giulia, the G70 is available with a manual transmission mated to the 2.0 turbo. The gearbox is smooth and throws are light, and it definitely ups the driving fun ante.
I'm not sure how many people in the US are actually going to buy a G70 with the manual transmission, especially given the dwindling state of sedan sales, but this feels like a calculated move on the part of Genesis to build a little bit of performance credibility with the diehards. Smart move, new kid.
The Audi A4, BMW 3 Series, Alfa Romeo Giulia, and Mercedes C-Class are performance juggernauts. Add to that list the Infiniti Q50 and Lexus IS, and you've got a competitive set that might keep designers and engineers up at night.
But with great value, solid styling, and exceptional dynamics, Genesis just got their hat well into the compact sports sedan ring with a ridiculously accurate throw. And I, in turn, tip my proverbial hat to them. Okay, now get out of here, because I need to drive this thing a lot more.